What if I could show you how to create one function somewhere inside of Storyline 360 and then call that same function with different parameters, just push in different things into that function on any page inside of your course? Well, that is where global functions come into play. And that's what I'm going to talk about today. One of the things that's always bugged me about Storyline triggers is the fact that I cannot reuse them. I can't pass in, like, set it up once and then pass in different things to reuse basically the same type of trigger that I'm doing. I have to have duplicate types of triggers. I have to have a trigger for adding the score on every single button instead of just saying, okay, add score and add 5 points to this one, add 10 points this time. So if you're wanting to do like set up code and reuse it, this is where this comes into play. Now I do have to give props to James Kingsley. He's the one in the testing of the JavaScript API. He's the one that actually suggested this that I had not even thought about. So I went and I tested it and I played around with it and absolutely fell in love with just doing it this way. Not sure if it's the right, you know, way to do it, but at least this works for what I've been testing. So let's go ahead and dive into Storyline here. And right now I just like to keep it simple. This is essentially just some place where I'm going to set this function and then I'm going to call it from different pages. I like to keep the code as simple as possible so it doesn't overwhelm you, especially if you're new to it. And I am currently in the midst of creating my Storyline in JavaScript course. So if you're new to JavaScript, you can check that out by going to learningdojo.ninja. But right here, if I come into my variables, you can see right here score. So I have a variable inside of Storyline. Now, what I want to do is I want to add different points to the score at different times. Now, I can do this through a trigger. This isn't that hard through doing just a basic trigger. And so don't just say, hey, Jeff, why not just use a trigger? Because, again, just trying to keep it as simple as possible, I want to show you how I can set up this function. And you can do more with that function. So instead of just adding, maybe I can go ahead and divide and add percentages and do complicated math. So that's the real benefit of it. All right, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to set that global function. So as soon as you come to the page, what I want to do is add on a JavaScript trigger that will set that global function. So I'm going to click on execute JavaScript. So scroll down here, and there is my execute JavaScript, and I'm going to click on this little red JavaScript to bring up the JavaScript there. Now I'll create a function. For those of you who don't know, a function is a block of code. And it is something that you could reuse over and over. And it's basically like a group of triggers inside of Storyline. If I was able to group triggers together, and triggers are basically commands, and then I can basically have different commands run at the same time. It's like a group of triggers. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and just say run. The name of the function can be anything that you want to name it. So let's pass in a parameter, and that parameter I'm just going to give a letter A. Then I'll do open curly bracket, close curly bracket, and then this is where the list of commands go in. That way I have this parameter that anytime somebody calls this function, I basically can add in the parentheses, I can go in and say, okay, here's the new value. And based on that value, I can do whatever I want to. So let's go in and grab the score, the current score. So I'll come in and grab that. So all I have to do to grab that now is actually just do get var. And then inside of get var, I just pass in, and let's actually store this in a different variable so we can add to it actually. So let's go in and just say let current score equal, and then we'll say get var. So this is get the variable. And then we're going to say open close parentheses, and then open close quotes. We're going to pass in the name of that. And this has to be exactly how you named it inside of the variables. And we're going to grab the score. Because the score is a number, we can add to it. So that's one of the important steps is if you have a text variable and you're trying to add to it, that's not going to work. All right, so we got the score now. Now we can have an updated score. So let's say let updated score equal, and then we're going to go ahead and say current score, whatever the current score is, and then we're going to say plus A. So whatever parameter we pass in there. You could do this with the trigger like I mentioned, but just to kind of keep it as simple as possible, I'm just showing how you can do this, but then I could do more. I could divide it, I can get the remainder of a number, I can get the percentage of a number. There's a lot more that you can do here. Now that's the updated score, and now I'm gonna set the variable back. So I'm gonna do set var, and we're gonna do score, We're going to pass it back into the score, and then we're going to say updated score is what we're passing in, whatever the updated value is here. So that is our updated score. I'm going to go ahead and just end that with the parentheses and end that with a semicolon there. It's taking in whatever we pass it in, it's adding it to the score, and it's updating the score at that point. Simple as that. I'm going to go ahead and click OK here. And we're doing this when the timeline starts. But there's one more important thing. Let me actually bring this back up. In order for us to see this function from other triggers, we have to elevate this function. This has to become a global function. Because right now, when you add a code inside of a trigger, it gets placed inside of the user.js file, but it gets placed inside of another function inside of that user.js. So it's not, if you're aware of anything like scope or anything like that with JavaScript, it's not part of that universal scope. So anywhere else that you're trying to call that function, it doesn't know about it. So we're elevating it and we're putting it at the top, basically, so we can call that. To do that is just one simple line of code. So I can come in here and say window, which is the browser, so whatever the browser is, we're going to say window.runcode. So anytime I use runcode is going to equal this name of the function, and it's going to be whatever the name is of that function that I've called there. Simple as that. Now I can go in and I can call that function and pass in the parameters because I've elevated that function. It has now become a global function, so I can call it at any time. And that's really the key. Whatever function that you're creating inside of JavaScript, you basically just elevate it, you know, start it out when the timeline starts, elevate it, and then anytime you want to call it, which I'll show a different example here in a second, but then you want to, anytime you want to call it, you just pass in the parameter. So I'm going to go ahead and click OK here, and then click OK here. Now, when I want to call that function on a different page, all I have to do here is come in and add or click the button I want to add the trigger on. Then we're going to execute the JavaScript. We're going to do this when the user clicks on this button here. And now all I have to do is type in the name of the function. So I just say run code, and then inside of the parentheses, I pass in the parameter that I want to do. Again, if this is all new to you, go ahead and check out that course, my Storyline in JavaScript course. I talk about what parameters are, I talk about functions, I talk about all of that. So now here is the run code, as simple as that. It is now easy, instead of having to duplicate that same function here that I did in the other trigger, I can now just call that same function here. And it can reference anything that I'm referencing, anything, you know, instead of having to duplicate, you know, my reference objects, I basically just call that and it's already referenced in that other area, which I'll show an example of that in my other one. But let's go ahead and click OK. Just make sure that that took here. There we go. Click OK. And I'm going to add a different one. I'm going to add 30 here. This is the nice thing about having reusable functions is you can just pass in whatever parameter you want here. So let's add 30 and then just hit semicolon and hit OK. Now let's preview this entire project. And I'll show you a real world example of like referencing an object for animation. And instead of having to duplicate the same code for animation, I just basically pass in wherever I want it to move. So I'll talk about that next. So this has set the initial score. Nothing we need to do here. It did that as soon as the timeline loaded. Now I can come in here and you can see the score is right now 0. But if I click on add 15, oh, I think we're getting an error. Let's check out this error here. Run code is not defined. Oh, let me go ahead and just make sure that that is working. Let's go back in here. Oh, I have a misspelling right here. It is trying to find a run code, but I had run C there. I don't like to edit out all of my mistakes here. So you can see you might have to look through your code, making sure that the names are the same and everything. So you can see here, run code, click OK, and now it should work. So let's go ahead and preview that. Troubleshooting when it comes to JavaScript is part of the game. Knowing where to check your code, knowing where to look to see everything is if everything's okay, that is just part of JavaScript. All right, so let's go ahead and go to the next page and click on add. There we go. It's now added 15. Let's go to the next page. So the next page is the same layout here, but if I click on add 30, it'll now add 30. So I've been able to reuse that same function. Now, this is a simple example, and this is something you can do within triggers, like I mentioned. But let's take a look at something that you can't do within triggers. So let's go ahead and minimize this one. In this one, I have this animation. This animation of this person that's going to go into different spots. This is using the GSAP library. If you haven't checked out the GSAP library, the Green Sock Animation Library, go ahead and check out the video here as well. That will show you all the different things that you can do for more accurate positioning and animations and easing and other things like that. So what I'm doing here is I'm setting this initial function. I'm actually doing a lot with like the cards that come down here. But down here, this is where I want you to focus on, is I'm grabbing Eduardo. So this is Eduardo right here. And I only have to reference him in one spot because I'm animating him several times, but I don't have to re-reference him if I make this a global function. Now inside of this global function, which is animate Eduardo, I want to have two parameters, and you separate two parameters by a comma. And then inside of there, here is your green sock animation. You basically say, okay, Eduardo is who I want to animate. And I have the letter A for the first parameter as the X value and the Y value, which X goes across, Y goes up and down. So the Y value is going to be whatever the B parameter is. And then I do the easing. The nice thing about this is if I decide to change the easing to something else, like a bounce, for example, I just have to change it in one spot. Because it's a global function, I just have this in one area and I don't have to change that for all 10 different triggers that I may have. All right, so now I'm doing the same thing here. So I'm saying window.animateEduardo equals animateEduardo. So it's making it the global function. That's it. So now if I come into this option here, I don't even have to reference Eduardo. I just do animate Eduardo and I pass in the X value, which is going to be 313, and I pass in the Y value. If I was not to do this, if I was to reference Eduardo in every single trigger and then animates in every single trigger as well, it would actually look something like this. I did not change this on purpose. I would have to have Eduardo here and I'd have to have this here. So what happens is if I swap out Eduardo for somebody else, I'd have to go into five different triggers and get the new ID for all five different triggers. So having it as a global function just has one spot where I get Eduardo's ID instead of having it in all different areas. And I also have to go into different triggers to update the X and the Y value, which I technically kind of have to do that part still, but if I change the easing, I have to change that in all five different triggers as well. That is it. So on every other trigger, I basically just pass in the different X and I pass in the different Y. I could add more parameters. You can have, okay, what if I want to change the easing on every single one of them? Make that a parameter. And then when you call the function, just pass in a different easing. So it's just so flexible as far as what you can do there. And thanks to James for kind of calling that out. And I just wanted to play around with that. Thought it was useful enough for me to be able to create a video on this. If you want to check out more, head on over to my website at learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out all my previous blog posts. If you're interested in JavaScript, all you have to do is select JavaScript here and it will filter out all my JavaScript videos. But like I mentioned, I also do have courses and I am currently working on, which is available right now, it's in progress right now. So you can see here, JavaScript and Articulate Storyline 360. But if you're new to Storyline, you can also check out my full Storyline course, XAPI Fundamentals, Articulate, Rise, and more. You can also download free templates. If you go into the template section, I have templates in Storyline. I also have XAPI templates as well. If you like this video, head on over to my YouTube channel, click the like button and subscribe to my channel, as well as hit the bell notification so you get notified of all future videos as they come out. That really helps my channel, allows me to continue to grow. And really the goal for this channel is to help you push the boundaries of e-learning tools and to become the best learning developer that you can be. So if you have any other suggestions, things that you're struggling with, things that you want to see, go ahead and comment in the YouTube channel or on my blog post and say, hey, I want to see more of this, or I really want to see this. That's the kind of thing that I can add to my backlog for future videos. That's all I have for today. So thanks everyone, and I'll see you next time.